वासुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय देवहूतिर्
उवाच
उवाच
काचित्
काचित्
त्वयि
त्वयि
उचिता
उचिता
भक्ति
भक्ति
कीदृशी
कीदृशी
मम गोचरा
मम गोचरा
यया
यया
पदम
पदम
ते काचित्वयुचिता भक्ति
काचित्वयुचिता भक्ति
काचित्वयुचिता भक्ति
काचित्वयुचिता भक्ति
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
अञ्जसान् वाष्णवाहम्
अञ्जसान् वाष्णवाहम्
अञ्जसा वाष्णवाहम्
अञ्जसा वाष्णवाहम्
देवहूतिरुवाच
देवहूतिरुवाच
काचित्त्वयुचिता भक्ति
काचित्त्वयुचिता भक्ति
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
अञ्जसान् वाष्णवाहम्
अञ्जसान् वाष्णवाहम्
देवहूतिरुवाच
देवहूतिरुवाच
काचित्त्वयुचिता भक्ति
काचित्त्वयुचिता भक्ति
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
अञ्जसान् वाष्णवाहम्
अञ्जसान् वाष्णवाहम्
देवहूतिरुवाच
देवहूतिरुवाच
काचित्त्वयुचिता भक्ति
काचित्त्वयुचिता भक्ति
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
कीदृशि मम गोचरा
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
यया परं ते निर्वाणम्
अञ्जसान् वाष्णवाहम्
अञ्जसान् वाष्णवाहम्
On hearing the statement of the Lord, Devahuti inquired, What kind of devotional service is worth developing and practicing to help me easily and immediately attain to the service of your lotus feet?
Kaschittai uchita bhakti kidrishi mamagochara जया पदंग से निर्माणम अन्यशान वासनवा अहम सो इट इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ द डिसाइपल डिसाइपल मीन्स एवरीवन ह्यूमन ह्यूमन बॉडी वन हु हैज गॉट ह्यूमन बॉडी अर्थात ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा दिस इज द वेदांत सूत्र एडवाइस अतः ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा दिस लाइफ ह्यूमन लाइफ इज मेंट फॉर इंक्वायरी व्हाट इज दैट इंक्वायरी ब्रह्म इंक्वायरी अबाउट द एब्सोल्यूट ट्रूथ सो The Vedic injunction is that if you are inquisitive about self-realization, Brahma-realization, then you should approach a guru. Therefore, here Devahuti is accepting his son, the exalted son, incarnation of God, Kapildev, Inquiry from him. That is the Vaishnava process. Vaishnava process is not to speculate oneself. If one is actually inquisitive, to know about the Absolute Truth, he must approach a bona fide spiritual master. Adu Gurbhasram. The first business is to find out Guru. Guru Krishna Kripaya Pai Bhakti Lata Bij, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says. At the present moment, this is a mentality. Of course, they have got some bad experience. But the process is that you must go to a Guru. That is Vedic injunction. Tasmat Gurum Prapadyeta. Tad vijnanartham sa gurum eva avigacchet. Avigacchet means must. There is no other alternative. In the Bhagavad Gita also it is said, tad vidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadakshanti tad jnanam jnanina tatta darshina. If we actually are very serious to get out of the clutches of Maya, this repetition of birth, death, old age and disease, and get back our original spiritual life, eternal life. Na hannati hannamane sarire. That is our real identification. We do not die after the annihilation of this body. But you are so dull by the influence of Maya, we think that death is inevitable. No. Why death is inevitable? Death can be avoided. Birth can be avoided. Disease can be avoided. But we do not know, we have become so dull. We do not know how to overcome. We are busy temporary inconveniences. The whole world is struggling. Some temporary. The real business is atantika dukkha nirvritti. Everyone is trying to minimize the miserable condition, but they are busy for temporary miserable condition. But the Vedic knowledge is how to mitigate the topmost miserable condition. That topmost miserable condition is the repetition of birth, death and old age. Janma mittu jarabhyadhi dukkha dosha anudarshana. We should not be very much afflicted with these temporary things. We must have the sense how to solve the ultimate miserable condition of life. That tadvijnanat. In order to know that science, sa guru eva vigacchet. If one is interested to know that science, then it is necessary to approach. Just like Arjuna was busy, perturbed that he has to fight with his relative, the other side, and they will be killed. And he was presenting so many problems that if I kill my brothers, my sister-in-laws will become widow, and they will be polluted, and there will be Varnasankar generation, then the whole world will be hell. In this way he was thinking. The immediate material problems. But when, after arguing with Krishna, he could not find out any solution, then Arjuna submitted to Krishna, Shishyasti aham, sadhimam prapannam. My dear Krishna, now I don't want to talk with you as friend, because friendly talk, the talking will be very much, but there will be no benefit. Generally we do so. We talk with some person, some friend, without any utility, just to waste time. That is not the way. If you go and talk with some person, then you must derive some benefit. The aim should be there. Otherwise, simply waste of time. And it is the injunction of the Shastra that unless one is submissive, superior man should not talk. Tad-vidhi pranipatena. Unless one is submissive, he will not be able to accept the sublime instruction. So one has to become submissive. That submissiveness Krishna Arjuna is teaching us. Shishyasteham sadhimang prapannam. I am now submitting myself to you, not that equal position with you, friend and friend equal position, that I am giving up. I am becoming your disciple, submissive. Shishyasteham sadhimang prapannam. Prapannam means submissive. And that is the way. You cannot speculate. Your speculation has no value. Athapi tedeva chirang vichinna. Chirang vichinna. You can go on speculating for many births, many years. Still you will not be able to understand the ultimate goal of your life. It is not possible. Therefore, all the shastras, they advise that you go to a guru. Guru means weighty, one who has got more weight, one who can teach you. Because everyone thinks that I am learned, I am all learned. Who can teach me? No. Nobody is like that. Everyone requires instruction. Therefore, the Vedic system is adu gurbhasrayam, to make one's life fruitful, one must approach Guru. Therefore, our system is, Vedic system is, from the very beginning, a child, a boy, is sent to Gurukul to learn. Not that automatically one learns. One must go to Gurukul, brahmachari. Brahmachari goes to Guru and he works like a menial servant. He may be a son of a big Brahmin or big king, it doesn't matter. The one who goes to Gurukul, he immediately becomes the menial servant of Guru. This is the system. That means Guru can order him to act any, I mean say, low-class service, still he is prepared to do it. This is the business of brahmachari. And he takes all trouble, and childhood, he doesn't mind. Even Krishna, he went to Gurukul to teach us. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, what is the use of his going to Gurukul? No, he's teaching. Aponi achari prabhu jivere shikha. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also accepted Guru. And teacher, Guru mare murkha dekhi korila sasan. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was talking with Prakashananda Saraswati, Prakashananda Saraswati was very learned scholar and he knew that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was also a very great scholar. So he was criticizing him that this sannyasi from Bengal who has come to Benaras is simply chanting and dancing and does not give attention in the reading of Vedanta, he is not a bona fide sannyasi. He is sentimental. You are thinking like that. But one Brahmin, Maharashtriya Brahmin, he arranged a meeting with Prakashananda Saraswati and Lord Chaitanya. There was discussion. So Prakashananda Saraswati inquired from him that you are a sannyasi, instead of giving our attention in the matter of reading Vedanta Sutra, Sankhya philosophy, what is this that you are chanting and dancing? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replied that my guru found me. I am a fool number one. Guru mare murkhode. I am not very much learned. So he said, my guru said that you cannot read Vedanta Sutra. But actually Vedanta Sutra, Vedanta philosophy, is not meant for ordinarily learned person. It requires great knowledge in Sanskrit language and philosophy. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took the part of ordinary person at the present moment, that guru mare murkho dekhi korilo shasan. Generally people are not so learned that they can understand Vedanta Sutra. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taking the part of the murkho society, the illiterate, ignorant society, he said that I cannot read Vedanta Sutra. It is not possible. He advised me to chant Hare Krishna. And I am doing that. And I am getting the result. So, at the present moment, especially in Kali Yuga, they are not very much educated. They are simply busy how to earn some money and fill up the belly, that's all. They are not no more interested in Vedanta Sutra. Manda. Manda means very slow or very bad. They are so badly infected with the influence of Maya, they do not care to understand that there is life after death, and that life may be anything of this 8,400,000 forms of life, and if I become one of them, if I become tree, if I become cat, if I become dog or insect, or even human being, then if I am in a very inconvenient condition, then they do not care to know. Sometimes they say, never mind, if I become a dog, what is the wrong there? I'll forget everything. People say, in Western countries, even the university students, they say, they don't show ignorance. Therefore, they have been described as manda. Formerly, especially in India, the Chaturbarnam, the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, so at least the most intelligent class of men, the Brahmanas, they were interested to understand Brahma Jigyasa, Athata Brahma Jigyasa. But at the present moment, they are all Shudras. They are not interested about Brahma Jigyasa. They are interested how to get more money, where the cinema, where what picture is going. They are interested in that. Not about Brahma Jigyasa. But the human life is meant for that purpose only. Therefore, we learn from Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna is personally teaching us. He is accepting Krishna as Guru. Shishyastiham. Krishna, now I become your disciple. Not that I remain as your friend. Friend-to-friend talk is not very serious. Now I want to talk with serious you become my spiritual master, you teach me, and I'll take your lesson. This should be the... It is not meant for only Arjuna. It is meant for everyone, that he must find out a guru. The first guru is Krishna. And anyone who is Krishna's representative, he is guru. Guru is Krishna, the original guru. And if Krishna representative is found, is available, then he is also guru. Just like you are a businessman, and anybody goes to canvas for business to get some order for your business, he is your representative. It is not very difficult to understand. If he is your representative and talks something nonsense, then he is not your representative. He is cheating you. He is taking your money and doing something else. No. Real representative is he who canvassing for Krishna. He is not canvassing for himself, that I have become Krishna. No, he is not guru. He is cheater. The representative is he who canvasses business for Krishna. That is guru. Krishna wants this business. What is that? You rascal, give up everything and surrender unto me. Sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam saranam vraja. Krishna wants this business. And Krishna's representative also says that you give up everything, simply surrender to Krishna. This is Krishna's representative. Sometimes we are very much eulogized, I have done a wonderful thing, but I have done as representative of Krishna. Same thing. I have told all these boys and girls nothing magic. I never showed any gold-making magic. I simply said to them that here is Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You surrender unto Him. That's all. Ask anything. I never said anything. Well, that is actually representative. Anyone can become Krishna's representative. Everyone. Especially Indians, they should become Krishna's representative. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. Bharat bhumite manushya janma haila ja, janma sarthak kari karo paropokar. Paropokar means the whole world does not know about the message of Krishna. Therefore, it is the greatest welfare activities to carry this message and inform them. This is the work of Krishna's representative. And any Indian can do it, but they will not do it. They will take Bhagavad Gita and speak their hajpaj, that's all. That is not Krishna's representative. Therefore, it has not been successful. For the last 200 years, so many Swamis and yogis went to foreign countries, but nobody spoke about Krishna. Simply hajpaj. Therefore, there was not a single person accepted this cult, Vedic culture. That is practical. So, Arjuna, we are reading Bhagavad Gita, you can understand that Arjuna is a friend. Why he is accepting Krishna as guru? Why? He's a friend. He's talking equally, he's sitting equally, friend and friend, sometimes talking nonsense. Krishna in the 11th chapter, he was begging Krishna, forgive me. As a friend, I have misbehaved with you. And friend has got right that. Krishna did not mind for that. But he knew that Krishna, although he is my friend, he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, he is the proper person to become my guru. And he said also that the perplexity which I have been put into now in this battlefield, this cannot be solved by anyone else except yourself. That he said also. So this is the instruction we get from Bhagavad Gita. Everyone reads Bhagavad Gita, that we have to accept Krishna as the guru or Krishna's representative as guru. Tadvidhi panipatena pariprasnena sevaya. And we have to give service to such guru, and we have to surrender ourselves. Not that I accept you, guru, just to know how much you are learned, how much you can talk with me. Not with that spirit. Surrender. That I surrender unto you, sir. Shishyasteham, I have become shishya. Shishya means voluntarily accepting his ruling. Whatever guru will say, he will accept. That is called shishya. Shishya means ruling. Who accept, disciple means disciplinary measure. Whatever guru says, one who accepts, he becomes disciple. I don't care for my guru's order and still I am disciple. That is not accepting guru. Of course, it has become a fashion like that to have a guru, but don't care for guru. That is not, that will not help. Shishyasteham sadimang prapannam. And immediately Krishna, as soon as he accepted to become guru of Arjuna, he immediately chastised him. Asachyananusuchastam prajnavadangstabhasase gatasunna gatasunja nanusuchanti pandita. My dear Arjuna, you are not talking like a learned man. You are thinking that you are a very learned man, that you are talking with me, that what will happen to this, to that, if I fight, you have wasted so much time. But actually I find that you are a fool number one. You do not know anything. Asachyananusuchastam, because you are lamenting for things for which one should not lament. What is that? This body. You are thinking of this body of your relatives, and because they will be in the war, they will be killed, you are thinking like that. But actually, this is not the subject matter of pondering. The real subject matter is how to save the soul. Therefore, he began instructing that we are not this body, we are soul. Dehinasmin yatha dehi kaumara jovanam jara tatha dehantara prati. In this way, he gave first instruction that we are not this body. So here also, Devahiti is O-man. Everyone is less intelligent before his guru, especially O-man. Striya sudra tatha vaishya. Stepi janti parangati. But God or Krishna is open for everyone. It is not that Krishna is open for the Brahmanas, the learned scholar, or the Hindus, or the Muslim, or Christian. No. Krishna is open for everyone. Sriya Sudha Tathavisha. Stepi janti parangati. Māṅhi pārtha papāsritya jepiṣu pāpajuna. Even pāpajuni. Pāpajuni means low class. Just like in our country, we have got low class people, the cobbler, muchi, the chandalas, the dog eaters, they are considered as low class. So Krishna is open even for the low class. This is universal movement, Krishna consciousness. Because it is concerned with the soul, consciousness. Therefore you have named the word consciousness. Consciousness belongs to the soul. That is the symptom of presence of soul. At the present moment, because the soul is in the body, if I pinch your body, then you feel consciousness. feel pains or pleasure. But as soon as the soul is gone out of the body, if I chop off your body with a dagger, he will not protest. The consciousness is gone. Jena sarvamidam tatam avinashitu tadvidhi jena sarvamidam tatam, Krishna says. Sarvamidam, this body. This body, wherever you pinch, you feel pain. Why? Because the consciousness is there. The Krishna is mind is that consciousness is eternal. Not this body. Avinashiti tatvidhi jina sarvamidam tatam. So that consciousness is eternal. Therefore, we have to purify our consciousness. Then our life is successful. Consciousness will go with us. At the time of death, the consciousness carries me to another body. Sukha, the fine or the subtle body, the mind, intelligence and ego. But we do not see that mind, intelligence and ego and the soul, it is still finer. Mind is, we know you have got mind, you know I have got mind, but you do not see. I know you have got intelligence, you know I got intelligence, but you cannot see. But how the mind, intelligence carry the soul to another body, how you can see? We see that this gross body is stopped. We say it is everything finished. Because we have got gross intelligence. We have no sukha in. Therefore, we have to approach Guru. Just like Arjuna approached Guru. And Arjuna Krishna teaching that you are thinking of this body like a rascal. Nanu sochanti pandita. He said in a very gentlemanly language, no learned man thinks like that. That means you are a fool. Nanu sochanti pandita. You are not a pandit. You are a fool. You try to understand that real life is for the soul. Therefore, you should take care of the soul. The whole Vedic language, Vedic education means to take care of the soul. The soul is entangled, embodied, encased in this material affair, and he is suffering. And to rescue him, to get him out of this material clutches, that is called education. That is called education. And for that education, one has to approach a proper guru, like Kapil Dev. Kapil Dev is incarnation of Krishna. So, guru is there, Krishna, and his instruction is there in the Bhagavad Gita. Why you are not taking advantage? You have become so foolish. The instruction is there, guru is there. Somebody says that Arjuna had the opportunity, good opportunity, to talk with Krishna face to face, but we haven't got it. What is that talk? The talk is already there. You hear it from his representative, the same instruction. Where is the difficulty? But they will not do that. They will take Bhagavad Gita and misinterpret in a foolish way, in a rascaldom, and spoil his career and others' career. That's all. Otherwise, everything is there. Where is the difficulty? Krishna says that there is the owner of the body within the body, and he has explained in so many ways, acchidyam, adajyam, distinguishing the quality, that the soul is never to be cut into pieces, acchidyam. It cannot be burned into the fire. It cannot be moistened by water. That means everything matter, there is interaction. Any matter will be interacted by another matter. But the soul is not anything of this material world. In the material world, any hard thing, the iron, the stone, can be cut into pieces if you have got the instrument. But Krishna says the soul is achidyam. It cannot be cut into pieces. So it is above all material action and reaction. Adajyam, in material, even the iron can be melted, in the stone can be melted nowadays. But adajyam, asusyam, in so many ways. That means it is different from this material thing, the soul. Therefore, na hannate hannamane sarire. This instruction, the common sense is that if my position is like that, achidyam adajyam, na hannate hannamane sarire, then what is that life? How I can attain that life? That is brahma jigyasa. One should be inquisitive. If we remain fools and rascals like cats and dogs to maintain this body only, then what is the benefit of this human life? Human life is meant for understanding this science, that I am not this body, but I am busy with this bodily comfort. I am soul within the body. What I am doing for that? Which is Brahma. This is required. Therefore, tad vijnanartham sa guru meva abhigacchet. If you want to learn about that, then you must find out a guru. What kind of guru? Just like Kapil Dev, Krishna, or his representative. Not a bogus guru. Then you will be cheated. Andhajathandhirupaniyamana. The so-called rascal guru, he does not know also what is the aim of life. And if he makes some disciples, then Shastra says, Andhajathandhirupaniyamana. One blind man is trying to guide many other blind men. So what is the benefit? There is no benefit. So if you want to be guided by somebody, he must have open eyes. Tatta darshina upadakshanti tat jnanam. Tat jnanina tatta darshina. Darshi. Darshi man who has got eyes to see what is the absolute truth. Don't go to a blind man who has no knowledge of the absolute truth. The absolute truth is there, Krishna. The sun is there. Everyone can see. Sun is not hiding, but I am hiding. I am closing my door. How can I see sun? Come to the field, open to the sun, and you will see sun, there is light. Similarly, God is there, Krishna. You come to Krishna, take his lesson from Bhagavad Gita, you learn what is God. But the rascals will not do that. They will manufacture some meaning. This meaning, this meaning, that, this meaning, that. They will not accept Krishna. That is the difficulty. Otherwise, there is no difficulty. Even there is difficulty. One can say that, yes, it is all right, Krishna's instruction is there, Krishna's deity is there, but it's still, how can I see? How can I understand? There is obstinacy. That Krishna is so kind. All right, you see me in the water. Come on. Rasu ham apsukantiya prabhasmi sasisurujaya. Why don't you see me? You are seeing water, and why you take water? For satisfying your thirst. And that quality of satisfying your thirst, I am, Krishna says. So if you think of Krishna, when you become satisfied by drinking water, if you think of Krishna, you become one step advanced, immediate. Is that very difficult? Nothing difficult, but we are obstinate, we'll not do that. We'll not try to understand Krishna, we'll not take Krishna's instruction. Why it is so? Maya. It is very, very strong. As soon as I will try to accept Krishna as the Supreme Lord, I will whisper in my ear, no, no, no. There are many gods. Why you are accepting Krishna? Immediately. There are many gods. Why are you accepting Krishna? But Shastra says, Krishnastu Bhagavan Sayam. Ishara Parama Krishna. That will not hear. I will not take this lesson from the Shastra, from the Acharyas. At least in India, we have got big, big Acharyas. Ramanucharya, Madhyacharya, Vishnu Swami, even Shankaracharya, even Guru Nanak. They have accepted all Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Why should we not? Why I shall be another competitor to Krishna? This is our misfortune. Therefore, Bhagavan says, Namanga duskirtina murha parvadanti naradhama. Because we are sinful, because we are rascals, we do not accept Krishna as the Supreme Personality of God. You are searching after Krishna, making speculation, philosophical. Don't do that. Accept Krishna and be in Krishna consciousness and be